Good morning, students. In this lecture, we will study about a book of class 8 that is Click to Learn. And you can see the image of book on your screen. This book is based on Windows 7 and MS Office 2010. You can see various versions of Windows are present in market, from Windows 95, 98, 2000, Windows Vista, Windows XP, and Windows 7, 8, 8.1, Windows 10. So this is based on Windows 7. And MS Office have also different versions, like Office 2007 is there, Office 2010, 13, 16, 19 is also there in market. Now this page you can see contents or index. You can see computer networking, first chapter, then second is cascading a style sheet. And next is let's learn Access. Okay, so we start with the first page, that is page number 5. Now this chapter number 1 is computer networking. So first question arises in our mind is, what is computer network? Computer network means connection of more than one computer for a purpose. Now what is that purpose? For sharing information, data and resources. Information, data and resources I will discuss. Information you understood. For example, we are calling each other for using a phone. Phone is also a category of computer. I have already discussed in previous lecture. Now, calling means sharing of data. Then data, information and resources. Regarding resources, I will tell, for example, printer sharing. Suppose I have 50 computers. So how many printers I will require? 50. Only one is required, just because of the networking. Via networking cable, we connect a printer and all 50 computer will be able to give print on a single printer, just because of networking. So let's start. You can clearly see on your screen, first paragraph, in recent few years, computer has emerged as a major source of communication, which has increased the utility of this device many times. All this has happened due to the connectivity of two or more computing devices through some communication channel, enabling them to quickly share their information and resources with each other. In your daily life, day-to-day life, you make use of various type of networks like railway, cable TV, telephone network, postal network. Now, different categories of network have been explained in this paragraph, like cable TV network, then railway network, postal network. Now different, see, railway network is there, it provides transfer of objects, 3D objects in our daily life. Now these have some limitations in the sense, see, this world is 3D, so we have only third dimension, we don't have fourth dimension so far. But in computer it is multi-dimension. For example, you see any website like Facebook. So we can connect to million of people at the same time. It is not requiring any kind of physical objects. It require only memory and processing capacity of server of the computer. Now see here, in day-to-day life, you make use of various types of network, right? Like railway network. Network means one starting point is there, then we have to go to a destination via different stops. That is what network. So similarly, in computer networks, we also use gateways, routers, repeaters and many other devices like modem, also modulator, demodulator. Next, you can see computer network is a collection of computers connected to share information and resources with each other. The computers are connected using communication media such as cable, telephone, line or satellite. Now connection of the computer with each other. We can connect computer using cables like LAN, MAN, WAN, then wireless connection and Ethernet port, RJ45 cables. So, and Cat6, Cat5e cables. So this we will be studying. Next is computer network enables computer to share hardware devices, exchange files, etc. A network can be as small as just two computers sharing resource with each other, to as large as million of computer connected with each other to share their resources. Internet is one of the largest computer network which is spread across the world. Now computer network is started with one or two computer. For example, you can see, if we want to communicate with a different department, So we need to have telephone lines for communication. Initially we started with telephone lines. Telephones were there for communication. Later on these lines were extended for computer use, because computer is a better way to communicate. You can share file. Telephone you can only speak, but and one human should be there to listen. But here what we have, a machine is there which can store data at your single click. So that is a better technology. And previous generation of telephone lines were used via modem. We use modem, modulator, demodulator, so that we can communicate digital signal of computer via analog lines of telephone to the another computer receiver. You can see image, server and client computer. Server, you don't consider server as something different. Server is also a category of computer, and I have explained you computer works on IPO cycle, input process output, takes input, process and give output. Now that is a category of computer. And server, you can see central server is there, and next other computers are there known as client computer. Client computer ask for some resources, like asking for a file, and server computer delivers or communicate with each other. For example, computer 1 want to communicate with second or fifth, then server computer plays a major role. Now we see second page. Sorry, page 6, I think. Now see components of computer network. The various component of computer network are message, sender, receiver, transmission medium and protocol. Now message, you understood what we want to communicate, that is what is messages. Then sender, person who is sending information. Receiver, person who is receiving information. You can say computer who is receiving the information. Transmission medium, by which medium we are communicating the information. For example, wireless medium, wired medium, and different categories of wire medium. For example, you have twisted pair cable, coaxial cable, fiber optic cable. We will see in images. The next, transmission medium, it is a I have explained you. Then protocol. Protocol means set of rules. See, in computer we require strict rule, because it is not like real world. It is a very vast technology and very sharp technology. So we require some rules, strict rules, so that a user cannot do a particular category of task if he is not eligible for that job. For example, you cannot change somebody else's password of any social media account. So that is what rules are there, sets of rules that is given here. Message is a piece of information which is transferred across a network. This could be a text, voice, image, video or other media. Next, sender. Sender is a source of message. It could be a computer or a person who sends the message across the network. Receiver. Receiver is a person or a computer who receives the message sent by sender across the network and tries to understand what the sender wants to convey and respond accordingly. The next is transmission medium. It is a communication channel through which the message is transferred from sender to receiver on the network. Next is protocol. I have explained it is a set of rules used by two systems to communicate messages across the network. Next is advantages of networking. Large number of advantages are there of networking. If you want to share resources, lots of positive points are there. You can see data sharing. Multiple users can easily share information and resources at the same time over the network. For example, you take example of YouTube. A single file is uploaded and millions of users are continuously viewing the same file. Now suppose if a same video file is personally transferred to each computer, then person will download, then he will be able to see. The downloading time is there, and server is so powerful, it directly communicates. You just turn on the internet and you live, that is live viewing of file. Next is security. Network allows security by ensuring that only the authorized user may have access to files and application. Now security is also most important point. Security means, see, it your resources are being locked by the password. You can see OTPs are there, and very secure protocols are used. For example, HTTPS stand for Hypertext Transfer Protocol, S for secure. And I just want to advise you, for example, you are making online transaction, you always see for a symbol of padlock and HTTPS link, then only you enter password. If you see HTTP without a lock symbol, do not enter password. Next is efficiency. Any modification, upgradation and deletion of data software can be done at single point only using the network. Now efficiency, suppose I upload a video, if it is not appropriate I want to delete it. So it is my responsibility, my authority, and you can see easily delete. One person can upload, one person can delete, but if you transfer a file then it would be a problem. Next is cost effective. Hardware devices like printer, scanner, modems, etc. can be easily shared over a network. This reduces the cost of hardware equipment. I've already given you example. For example, a printer. Example was 50 computers. I'm having 50 computer. How many printer I require? 50 or 1? I think one printer is sufficient. Next we see applications of networking. Networking has become an important part of business, industries, education, entertainment. Internet has a large computer network. Some of the applications of this network are electronic messaging. We can send and receive emails to anyone in the part of the world by using internet. Now applications of networking. Application means for communication. What we can do? For example, electronic messages or email. Email we can send. We have an email ID, and on that ID person can communicate. Then more secure mediums, social media accounts are there, WhatsApp, Facebook, Instagram, and many other. Twitter is also there. Twitter, use of Twitter is a person who is well known by everybody, so he just make a tweet and million of user directly view. Now this is the next page. Electronic data interchange, EDI. EDI is a method of transferring data in a digital format over the internet. Then teleconferencing. Teleconferencing allows people to exchange and share their ideas with each other without being present there. It is of two types, video conferencing and voice conferencing. Now you have already done voice conference calling and video conference calling. Conference means more than one person communicating at the same time. That is voice conferencing and video conferencing. Next is electronic fund transfer, stand for EFT. For example, IMPS, NEFT, RTGS, bank transaction. IMPS means immediate payment system. NEFT means national electronic fund transfer. And RTGS means real time gross settlement. Next is types of computer network. Based on the geographical area across which the computer networks spread, it can be classified in the following ways. For example, first one is PAN. PAN stands for. Now see, just because of a small reason, I have to attach a new file. This is a new file, and I was explaining about types of network. Now this is PAN. PAN stands for personal area network. This type of network is used to provide connectivity to devices like printer, scanner, cell phone, tablet, etc. belonging to individual. The coverage area of this network is very small and is in range of just 5 to 10 meter. For example, I have 5 computers at my home. So for connection of these computer, I'll require a personal area network within a small range, 5 to 10 meters. So that is a personal area network. You can see the image. Printer connected, laptop, computer and mobile phone connected via a single network. It could be wired, it could be wireless network. But generally in mobile phone, we don't have any kind of Ethernet port. So we just require wireless connection. And at last, LAN, that is local area network. This type of network is spread within a small geographical area like a room, office, building or campus. All the computers and LAN are connected through cables or wired wireless link for communication. The number of computers in LAN can vary from 2 to several hundred computers. Due to the small geographical area covered by LAN, the communication speed is faster. And next page we will see later. Next here, local area network. Local area network is a little bigger network. From PAN, it is generally used in companies. For example, 50 or 60 computers are there, so that is a LAN. For example, in organization, in schools, if in a school there are 50 classes and we require connectivity of computers in all the classes, so we'll use LAN, local area network. One Ethernet cable would be there. And cables, regarding cable, I just tell you Cat5e and Cat6 cable are available. Good quality of cables are there. And inside the cable there are 8 wires. So later on we will study about this also. if it is there. So you understood local area network. LAN stand for local area network, PAN stand for personal area network, which is the smallest one. Then we have MAN also, metropolitan area network. It is connecting two cities. For example, we want connectivity between two branches of a bank. So that way we will use MAN, metropolitan area network, connecting two branches within a city. Then WAN, wide area network, WAN, wide area network, stand for internet connection of all the computers throughout the world. Okay, students, please like the channel and subscribe.